Hello everyone, welcome to G's Kitchen. Today we are going to see a very tasty savory recipe. I'm going to make mixture today. Come, let's see how to make it and what are the ingredients I am using. I'm G from G's Kitchen. So here I have kept all the items which I'm going to use. I have soaked this dal, this one and this one, both of this, chana dal and this one. I have soaked for 3 to 4 hours and I have drained without any water. And all the other ingredients are ready. Here I have taken the flour for the mixture, for the muruku actually. You can go and check out my video on making muruku. You can have a proper description of how I mix this flour. Basically, it's about 2 cups of gram flour and 1 cup of rice flour, or you can add 2 cups also, 2:2, and little bit of salt, and then little bit of ajwain I have added in. So now I'm going to add little bit of water and I'm going to make it into a dough, and all the other ingredients we are going to fry one by one. So first let's make the dough. So now into the flour I'm going to add water little by little. You don't need to add hot or cold water, this is normal room temperature water, and mix well and make it into a nice dough. If you want, you can add some hot oil. I'm adding little bit of oil and add water little by little and make it into a dough. Now the dough is ready. It should be at this consistency, and now I'm going to make the muruku for the mixture. I'm going to use this to make the muruku. I'm going to use this tiny whole one, just add that in, and I'm going to brush this with little bit of oil. Just brush this as well. And now let's make the muruku. Add enough of the dough inside. And I'm going to close this. Now it's ready. Come, let's make the muruku. Here I have kept 2 pots and the oil is heating up. Because to fasten the process, I'm doing like this. If you want, you can do it one at a time as well. So into the small one, I'm going to make the muruku, and into the big one, I'm going to start with this dal. I'm going to add in this dal. And let this fry until golden crispy. When you are making the muruku, make sure the oil is in medium heat and you always have the pan to take the muruku out, because it won't take much longer. And squeeze it nicely. This one will be very quick, so be near it and do it. It's ready, take it out. Just in no time, it won't take even 1 minute. While the muruku is getting done, slightly give it a mix. And you would have seen that I have not added any salt into anything. The salt will be added finally when we have done all the frying part. Only I have added salt into the murukku. Here you can see I have fried the murukku. I'm going to just break it into small pieces before I take out this dal. Here you can see I have broken the murukku into very small pieces. Now let's take out this dal. Now I'm going to start frying this one. Now you can see it has started floating up. That's when we know it's done. So now let's take this out. Next is going to be the groundnut, or we call it peanut, raw one. We are going to fry this until it is crispy. Now here I have got some cashew nuts. I'm going to fry this as well. Fry this until golden brown. This gives a nice flavor to this recipe. Since you will be continuously frying the dals and all the murukku and everything, every now and then, once one item is being fried, just switch off the flame for about 2 to 3 minutes and then switch it on. If not, the oil will get so hot and the items will start to burn. Now I'm going to fry some flattened rice. This is optional. If you like, you can fry it. And finally, I'm going to fry some garlic. I have sliced it very thin. I have sliced it into very thin slices. This is about one whole garlic. This gives a nice flavor to the mixture. And also, I'm going to fry some curry leaves to add in. Now the garlic has started browning. At this point, quickly take out the garlic, as the garlic will continue to cook even after we have taken it out. So it will be on a perfect texture if we take it at this time. And finally, switch off the flame. And I'm going to fry the curry leaves. Once the curry leaves are crispy, take it out. Now we have fried everything. While everything is hot, I'm going to add in enough salt. Don't add too much. And also, this is powdered red chili flakes. If you don't like red chili flakes, you can add chili powder as well. Add according to your taste. Mix well and then you can give it a taste test before you adding more salt or chili flake. Salt and chili flake always to your taste. No doubt we can buy all these things in shops, but nothing beats the homemade ones. They are always healthy and taste really good. Now our tasty homemade mixture is ready. Let's serve it. Tasty homemade savory mixture is ready. Make this at home and enjoy with your family and friends. Let me meet you with another interesting recipe. Thank you.